वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणि विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम्। येनाक्षरसमाम्नायम् अधिगम्यमहेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः। वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारञ्च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम्। वागर्थाविव सम्पृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरो वन्दे पार्वतीपरमेश्वरौ। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तशान्तशान्तिः। You can chant after me. We will chant the Prathama Vibhakti of Ajanta Pratipadikam, what we have seen, and also the demonstrative pronouns and the interrogative pronouns. You can chant after me. Akarantaha Pullingaha Rama Shabdaha. I'll chant, you can repeat after me. Okay. Okay. So, Prathama Vibhakti Ekavachanam, Ramaha, Vivachanam, Ramau, Vivachanam, Ramaha. Okay. So, this is Akaranta Pullinga Ramashabda. In the same way, all the Akaranta Pullinga Ramashabda can be declined. You can repeat after me. Okay. Ikarantaha Pullingaha Harishabdaha. This is Ikaranta Pullinga. Any Ikaranta Pullinga can be declined like Hari Shabda. We have seen only Prathama Vibhakti. And we know there are 7 plus 1 Vibhaktis. So we will be seeing one by one. So first you be thorough with this declension. Ukarantaha Pullingaha Guru Shabdaha.
गुरु
गुरु गुरवः
Guru,
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 guru, guru,
guru, guru,
yeah, again.
Guru,
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 then the Rikaranta. Rikaranta, we have two types of declension. One is based on the familial relation, other one is the agent based. Rikarantaha, pullingaha, pitrashabdaha.
Rikarantaha, pullingaha, pitrashabdaha.
Pita, pitaro, pitaraha.
Pita,
pitaro,
pitaraha.
Pita,
pitaro, pitaraha.
This is Rikaranta, Pitrashabda. In the same way, any familial relation, Rikaranta Shabda can be declined. So, when you see the word Pita, then immediately that Rikaranta Pratipadikam should come to your mind. Pitru, it is Pitrashabda. We'll be keep adding more and more Shabda when we learn. So, Pita, now you should be familiar. Pita means it is Rikaranta Shabda and the Pratipadikam is Pitru. Rikarantaha Pullingaha Kartra Shabdaha.
Rikarantaha Pullingaha Kartra Shabdaha.
Karta Kartaro Kartaraha.
Karta, kartarau, kartaraha.
Karta, kartaraha.
The difference between these two Rikaranta, it is in Dvivachanam.
And Bhavachanam.
So, remember this. So, similarly, here also, if you happen to see any Vachanam in Pratama Bhakti, you should be able to trace to the Pratipadikam Rikaranta, Kartru. This is Pratama Bhakti Ekavachanam, Divyavachanam, Bhagavachanam. So we will be adding one by one when we go further. In the last class, we saw some demonstrative and interrogative pronouns. That is Halanta Shabda. So far, we have seen Ajanta Pratipadikam. Now this is Halanta. Hal means consonants. So that which ends with consonants is called Halanta. There's some noise, is that please don't make any noise. I can hear some. Always use headphone, please. Now the next Shabda. Next demonstrative pronoun. Makarantaha Pullingaha Idam Shabdaha.
Makarantaha Pullingaha Idam Shabdaha.
Idam Ayam Imau Ime.
Ayam
Ayam
Imau Ime.
Again.
Ayam
Ayam
Imau Imau
Ime.
Ime.
So here, I am is Ekavachanam. Imau, Divachanam. Ime, Bhagavachanam. Now, when you see the Pratama Vibhakti Ekavachana form, I am, you should connect that to Idam Shabda. But looking at the form, there is no connection between Idam and I am. When you see Idam and I am, what is the connection? Both the forms are different. If you see Rama Shabda, Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha is there. So, Ramaha is there, so you can connect to the Pratipadikam Rama. Similarly, Hari also. Similarly, Guru also. But here, there is no connection. There is no connection in terms of the letters with the Shabda and the, with the Pratipadikam and the Padam. But that is how it is. So, I am means Idam. You should connect தி நாம பதம் அயம் பிரதி பிராதிபதிக்கம் இதம் இதம் சப்தஸ்ய பிரதமா விபக்தி ஏகவச்சன ரூபம் அயம் சிமிலர்லி இமௌ இமே. ஸோ வென் யூ கம் டு டெமான்ஸ்ட்ரேட்டிவ் ப்ரொனவுன்ஸ் த ஃபார்ம்ஸ் வில் பி டிஃப்ரெண்ட். திஸ் இஸ் ஃபார் தி புல்லிங்க அண்ட் வி ஆர் எட் டு ஸ்ரீ தி ஸ்ரீலிங்க அண்ட் நபும்சக்கலிங்க. ஸோ வி வில் பி கீப் ஆடிங் இட் டு இட் பட் அட் நவ் அட் திஸ் பாயிண்ட் ரிமெம்பர் ஐ எம் இமௌ இமே. ஓகே தென் த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் அண்ட் வி நோ த மீனிங் ஆஃப் ஐ இதம் இஸ் this, idam meaning this, that which is close, idam. Now the next one, dakarantaha pullingaha etad shabdaha
dakarantaha pullingaha etad shabdaha
yeshaha etau ete பிரதமாவிபக்தி ஏகவச்சனம் அண்ட் பிராதிபதிகம் இஸ் ஏதத். ஒன்லி த லெட்டர் ஏ இஸ் தேர் காமன் டு போத், அதர்வைஸ் தேர் இஸ் நோ கனெக்ஷன். பட் ஏஷஹா இஸ் தி பிரதமா விபக்தி ஏகவச்சன டிக்ளென்ஷன் ஆஃப் த பிராதிபதிகம் ஏதத். ஸோ தட் கனெக்ஷன் யூ மஸ்ட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், யூ மஸ்ட் நோ. இட் இஸ் நாட் ரேண்டம்லி த ஃபார்ம் இஸ் கிவன், யூ கேன் டிரைவ் த ஃபார்ம் ஏஷா, தட் இஸ் அ பிக் திங். ஃபார் தட் ஒன் ஹேஸ் டு ஸ்டடி இன் டெப்த் தி வியாக்கரணம். ஏதத் சப்தா இஸ் தேர் டு விச் யூ ஆட் தி பிரத்யா, pratyaya meaning suffix, and you get the form eshaha. A lot of rules are there, panini rules are there, apply that and you will get eshaha form. That we are not interested, instead of knowing all those things that we will be learning later at a very later stage, long way to go. But now eshaha, the form should be known. Form eshaha is connected to etat pratipadikam prathama vibhakti ekavachanam. Eshaha etau ete. Now the next one, etat meaning that which is very closer, closer compared to idam. This etat is refers to that which is very near. Next shabda, next is one is the interrogative pronoun. Makarantaha pullingaha kim shabdaha.
Makarantaha pullingaha kim shabdaha.
Kaha kau ke.
Kaha kau ke. Kaha kau ke.
கஹா இஸ் பிரதமா விபக்தி ஏகவச்சனம், கௌ த்விவச்சனம், கே பகுவச்சனம் ஆஃப் தி பிராதிபதிகம், கிம் இன் புல்லிங்க டிக்ளென்ஷன். கஹா கிம் மீன்ஸ் வாட், ஸோ கஹா கௌ கே. யூ கேன் ஹியர் சம் நாய்ஸ் இஸ் தேர், ப்ளீஸ் டோன்ட் மேக் எனி நாய்ஸ் வென் யூ மூவ் யுவர் டேபிள் பேப்பர், யூ கேன் எவ்ரிபடி கேன் ஹியர் த நாய்ஸ். So this is Makaranta Kim Shabda. And in the last class, we saw up to Dvivachanam. For both the demonstrative pronoun, for the demonstrative pronoun, for the both the demonstrative pronouns, Idam and Etat Shabda, we have seen up to Dvivachanam. You can refer to the previous class if you don't remember. So we have seen up to the Dvivachanam. The last one what we saw was Etau. Am I right? This is the one I think we saw. Etau and Imau.
Yes, Ji.
And this was the last example, I think, that this line. Etau vyagrau, etau gajau, etau drupau, etau drukshau. So this was the last line we saw. That is etad shabda. Etat Shabdasya Pratamabhakti Jivachanam. Up to that we saw. We will continue from where we left. So now you know the Pratamabhakti Ekavachanam and Jivachanam form of Idam and Etat Shabda. Now we will continue with the usage of Ime. Ime is, what is the Pratipadikam of Ime? The Pratipadikam of Idam Shabda, the Pratipadikam of Ime is?
Idam Shabda.
Idam, I myself. Pratamabhakti Bhagavacham, Ime. Ime refers to that which is close.
Close.
So, 1-3, the notation you understand, I think. Pratamabhakti 1, the numerator, and the denominator denotes the Vachanam, Bhagavacham. So, the masculine plural form of idam is ime. Ime, it is used to denote any masculine gender, plural things and objects. Also persons. So now, Sumatiji, you can read this.
Ime hamsaha. Ime hamsaha.
Is hamsaha?
Ha, and at the top you have a...
It's okay, but you read it. You read the word ime, and what is this word?
Hamsaha.
It is not hamsaha.
I'm sorry, I'm not able to...
Hum is correct. And what is this one next letter? Is it a short
Saha.
One?
No, it's long. Saha.
But you said you made it short.
Oh, I'm sorry. It is hum saha.
Hum saha. Ime?
Hum
saha.
Ime hum saha.
Like what shabda? Hum saha.
Hum saha, it is like... the Pratipadikam, it's ime is that hamsaha is
okay.
Ramashabda.
Yes, Ramashabda. Now we will look into these words. Ime hamsaha is that. What is ime?
Ime is bahuvachanam of idam shabdaha.
Idam shabda, bahuvacham, yeah. And it is pullinga.
It is makaranta, makarantaha, pullinga, idam shabdaha.
That's good. And hamsaha?
Amsaha is actually it is akarantaha pullingaha ram amsa shabdaha
hamsa shabdaha
it is amsa shabdaha it is hamsaha amsau amsaha
yeah that short is important if it is short if it is, it is short long okay. Long so we cannot okay. Make it long and short as we like it is hamsaha hamsaha Amsaha, when you say it is ekavachana. Amsaha, when you say bhagavachana. If you make it short and long, wrongly, it gives a different vachana. Amsaha, okay. When you say it is ekavachana. Amsaha, when you say bhagavachana. Here, ime is bhagavachana. Therefore, it must be hamsaha. It cannot be hamsaha. If you say hamsaha, then it must be what? If it is amsaha, then the demonstrative pronoun must be?
I am.
Amsaha. That's good. I am amsaha. Then, imau?
Imau, imau amsa, amsau.
Very good. Imau, amsau.
Amsau. Then, and ime, amsaha.
Me, amsaha. So, these are swans. So, both are 1-3, 1-3. Right? Pratama vibhakti, yes. Ekavachanam. So,
yes,
both are pratama vibhakti. Both are Bhagavachanam.
Bahuvachanam.
Both are Pullinga. That is important. We are doing now only pullinga. So that's why I'm not specifying it pullinga.
Okay.
If we study strilinga and napumsakalinga, then we have to specify it.
Sure. Right? Okay.
Okay.
Yes, yes, ji.
The next one now. Krishnanji, you can read the next one.
Ime vriddaha makaranta. Ime is makarantaha punlinga. Idam sabdaha. This is bahuvachanam. Ime is bahuvachanam. Vriddaha akarantaha punlinga. Vriddha sabdaha. This is also bahuvachanam. Ekavachanam is I am vriddaha. Imau vriddau. Ime vriddaha.
Good, very good.
1/3, both are.
Yeah, 1/3. And the next one. Arunaraji, you can read these sentences.
Ime shishyaha. Ime hastaha. Ime alayaha. Ime acharyaha.
Okay, you can take randomly one sentence and tell the pratipadikam and vachanam. Here in ime shishyaha, that shakara is a mudanya shakara shukam. It is a mistake. So try to change it. Shishyaha, it must be murdanya shakara, cerebral sha should come.
So ime shishyaha.
Yeah.
Ime is pradama pradama vibhakti. Ime is idam shabdaha pradama vibhakti bahuvachanam.
Good.
Pullingaha. Shishyaha is akarantaha pullingaha shishya shabdaha bahuvachanam pratama vibhakti bahuvachanam.
How do you decline shishya shabda?
Shishyaha, shishyau, shishyaha.
Very good.
So it will be idam shishyaha.
Idam shishyaha?
No, sorry. Ayam shishyaha, imau shishyau, ime shishyaha.
Very good. So what does it mean, ime shishyaha?
These are the students.
These are the students. Good. The next one. Uttaraji, you can read the next one.
Ime hastaha. Makarantaha pullingaha idam shabdaha. Ime is 1/3. So I am hastau, sorry, hastaha. Imau. Hastau. Ime. Astaha.
The summary sheet, what I sent in the previous class, you can take a printout of it and paste it in somewhere where you can see it often. So when you see it, you will remember it.
Okay.
Right? Okay. So ime astaha, what does it mean?
These are hands.
Astaha. Ime astaha. Good. Next one. Jayantiji, can read the next sentence.
Ime alayaha makarantaha pullingaha idam shabdaha bahuvachanam ime alayaha akarantaha pullingaha alaya shabdaha bahuvachanam and declension of ime is ayam alayaha imau alayau ime alayaha 1/3.
Okay. Ayam alayaha, this is a temple.
This is a temple.
Imau alayau, these two are temples. Or these are two temples. Or these are two temples. These two are two temples. Anyway, you can do the translation.
Okay.
You say imau alayau. Imau alayau. Imau means meaning two. Alayau also okay. Meaning two. So anyway, you can do the translation.
Okay.
Ime alayaha. These are
temples. Many temples. Can I say?
Yeah, you can say many temples.
Okay.
Bhagavachanam. Therefore, many is understood. So when you see many in the sentence and in the English sentence, when you want to translate, you don't have to look for the word many. You use plural. Ime. That ime or whatever it may be. Whatever if it is a proper noun, accordingly use the plural form of that shabda. So
okay.
Many need not be translated. It is understood in the language by the plural form.
Okay.
Okay, the next one. Gita ji.
Ime acharyaha.
Achar?
Acharyaha.
Acharyaha.
Okay. Acharyaha. Makarantaha pullingaha idam shabdaha. Pratama vibhakti bahuvachanam ime for akarantaha pullingaha acharya shabdaha ayam acharyaha imau acharyau ime acharyaha. That is this teacher. These two are teachers?
Yeah.
And last one will be these are many teachers.
These are teachers.
Okay.
So this is Pratama Vibhakti Bhagavachanam of Idam Shabda Ime usage. So you have to practice it by saying in Ekavachanam, Divachanam, Bhagavachanam. Any word you take, you can practice writing the sentences. One is writing. Second one is saying it. When you take a word, you've got a lot of words are there. You can see the previous lessons, a lot of Pullinga Shabda is there. In Akaranta, Ikaranta, Ukaranta, Rukaranta. So, you can take those words and form the sentences in Ekavachanam, Divachanam, and Bhagavachanam. You will find a lot of such words in the Gita also. Acharyaha, Acharyav Pitarav Pautraha, Shalaha Sambandhinastata. First chapter stroke. Acharyaha. Many acharyas. Arjuna saw many acharyas standing in the battlefield. Ime acharyaha. Pitaraha. Acharyav pitaraf pautraha. Pitaraha. What is pitaraha? Pitaraha is Bhagavachanam. Pita, pitarav, pitaraha. Many fathers. Many teachers, many fathers. Many fathers means whoever have assembled in the battlefield, in the Gita, they have their fathers. So, it's referring to the father of those people. So many people are there, therefore so many fathers will be there. Or so many people representing the role of a father for somebody. That is what denotes. Acharyaha, Pitaraha, Pautraha, grandsons. So all these are Bhagavachanam. Even in the first shloka itself, Mamakaha Pandavaha, Pandavaha is Bhagavachanam. Akarantaha Pullingaha, Pandava Shabdaha, Pandavaha, Pandavau, Pandavaha, Bhagavachanam. You can now identify the Pratama Vibhakti Bhagavachanam Shabda from any shloka, whether it is Gita or any text. This will be there. Okay. So when you read, you should be able to connect to what you have learned. Acharyaha is there. That's why the shloka came to my mind. Okay, then the next word now. Ete. So in Bhagavachanam, Ime we have seen, and now Ete. Ete is there. So what is the Pratipadikam of Ete? Ete is Pratama Vibhakti Bhagavachanam of the Pratipadikam.
Etad.
Etad. So Dakaranta. Etad. Dakarantaha pullingaha.
Pullingaha.
Etad. Meaning that which is very,
very close.
Closer. Close, closer. Close is idam. Closer is etad. And this is pullinga form. Ete. 1-3 is pullinga. Remember, 1-3 is pullinga. We will be saying that ete comes in other gender also. There you will see in what vachanam, what number it will come. We will see that later. But here, pullinga is 1-3. Remember, pullinga 1-3. So that refers to any all the beings or things or persons which are masculine. 1-3. Okay. Now, these sentences can read. Krishnamurti ji can read.
Ete balakaha.
Yeah,
Kakarantaha. Lingaha etat shabdaha. And
how do you decline Pratama Vibhakti Ekavachanam?
Pratama Vibhakti Ekavachanam. I'm sorry, Ekavachanam is Eshaha, Etau, I mean Divachanam and Ete Bahuvachanam.
Good.
Balakaha is Balakarantaha, Pullingaha, Balaka Shabdaha, Balakaha, Balakau, Balakaha. Ete Balakaha. These are all boys.
Oh, okay. Very good. Then what is the singular form? You make both the word into a singular form and dual form.
Esha balakaha. Etau balakau.
Very good.
Ete balakaha.
Ete balakaha. Right. The next one. Ramya ji, you can do this one.
Hete gardapa. Kartapaha.
Good.
Ete is the Bahuvachanam of Etat Pratipadikam, and Kartapaha is the Bahuvachanam of Kartapaha Pratipadikam.
Okay, what is Gardaba? Gardaba means donkey. Akarantaha Pullingaha Gardaba Shabdaha. Gardaba means donkey. So Ete Gardabaha means.
These are donkeys.
These are donkeys. So the donkeys which are, where are they? Is it close or closer?
They are closer.
They are closer. So what will be the Ekavachana form?
Ekavachana will be Eshaha Kartapa. Kartapa.
Eshaha?
Eshaha.
Rama Shabda, what do you say?
Yeah. Ramaha. So, Gardabaha.
That's it. Simple. Eshaha Gardabaha. This is a donkey. Right?
Yeah.
And Dvivachanam will be?
Hetau Gardabau.
Hetau Gardabau. And Bhagavachanam is?
Ete Gardabaha.
Ete Gardabaha. Very good. Okay. So here, in this sentence, in these sentences, you don't see the verb. You don't see the verb. I'm sharing another file. I need space to type. That's why. So in these sentences, what we have seen, okay, I'll do it there itself. Okay, Eshaha, Eshaha, Gardavaha. This is a donkey. That is the translation, right?
Yes.
Okay, how many donkeys are there?
Just one.
One. This is Ekavachan. So Eshaha is 1-3. Oh, sorry, 1-1. Gardabaha is also 1-1. Pratama Vibhakti Ekavachan. So Eshaha Gardabaha. This is a donkey. So this is that verb. It is not there in the sentence. If it is not, a sentence is not complete without a verb, right? If you literally translate yeshaha gardabaha, it means this donkey. What is this donkey? You are saying this donkey and your sentence is not complete. You started to say something, but you stopped. This donkey. But you want to say this is a donkey. Right? So the verb is not there. But literally, I mean really speaking, when you say Eshaha Gardabaha, Eshaha Gardabaha, this donkey. But it can be translated as this is a donkey. How do you do that? How do you know this is a donkey, that the verb that is there? Even though the verb is not explicitly specified in the sentence, it is understood. Asti. We have seen that. Eshaha gardabaha asti. This asti is understood. Asti means that is, that isness, its existence. Its existence is denoted by the verb asti. Asti or bhavati? That any word, any kriyapadam you can use. So asti bhavati, it's a kriyapadam. It is the verbal form. Asti bhavati. So yeshaha gardabaha asti. You can say. Even if you don't say asti, it is understood. It is there. Because, see, behind this there is a Vedantic truth is there. Anything which you refer in the world, in the universe, that has existence. You cannot refer to something which doesn't have existence. Even if you say something, you know, to your imagination, in the imagination it exists. Therefore, you cannot refer to, it is not possible to refer to any non-existent thing. So, whatever the word, whatever the word we use to refer anything, that object, it exists. Therefore, asti is appended along with the word. So, yeshaha asti, yeshaha gardabaha asti. Yeshaha, when you say this also, that exists. This exists. And you are having a proper noun, gardabaha. And gardabaha is qualified by eshaha, eshaha pronoun. So gardabaha exists. So that existence of gardabaha is denoted by the verbs asti bhavati. Even though the verbs are not explicitly given in the sentence, it is understood. We can supply. When you say, even in English also, this donkey you say. But in English, it is said to be an incorrect sentence. You have to say, this is a donkey. But in Sanskritam, it is not like. That is the beauty of the language also. The sentence, the very sentence itself, it shows the existence, that satta. Sat, chit, ananda, what we say in Vedanta, that sat, the existence, that is there. And that is understood by supplying the verb asti bhavati. Okay, asti bhavati is ekavachanam. Why ekavachanam? Because you are pointing to one donkey. Eshaha is one. Gardava is one. Therefore, asti must be what? It must be one.
One.
One. What is one? In Kriyapadam, there is no one. Gardaba is one, Pratama Vibhakti Ekavachanam. Yeshaha is one, Pratama Vibhakti Ekavachanam. And Gardaba and Asti is Pratama Purusha. It is third person. It is third person. There is no one there. If you refer to the notations, we use the Roman.
Roman three.
So it is Pratama Purusha Ekavachanam. So it is 3-1. That three is Roman, right? Pratama Purusha Ekavachanam. Because donkey is referring, it's a third person. Therefore, asti. It is Roman 3, bar 1. Bhavati also same. So, Eshaha Gardabaha Asti. And if it is Bhagu Vachanam, Eshaha is there. Eshaha Etau Gardabau. Here also, what is the verb? Here, Etau is 1-2. Etau is 1-2. Gardabau is 1-2. And you cannot put Asti Bhavati. Because Asti is Pratama Purusha, but Ekavachanam. And here Gardabhav is Bhagavachanam. Gardabhav is Bhagavachanam. Therefore, you cannot just copy paste the same thing, Asti Bhavati. This is wrong because it doesn't match in Vachanam. You cannot say Etau Gardabhav Asti. That's a wrong statement. Etau Gardabhav Bhavati. It's a wrong statement. This also must be made of the same Vachanam. Converted to the same Vachanam. Gardabhav is 1-2. Dvivachanam. Asti must be. Therefore, it must be Dvivachanam. In the place of Asti, Dvivachanam will come. And Dvivachana form is Staha. Dvivachana form is Staha. Sumataji, you can mute your mic. Dvivachana form is Staha. Asti Staha. Staha is Pratama Purusha Dvivachanam. It is not there in the sentence when you say Etau Gardabhav, but it is understood. These are two donkeys. So Staha. Staha is Pratama Purusha Dvivachanam. Kriyapadam, the verbal form denoting to two things which are present, that is Staha. Similarly, for Bhavati also, it must change. It is Bhavataha. Etau Gardabhav Bhavataha. All this Kriyapadam we are going to see later. That comes later. But now, some of you may be curious to know what it is. That's why I'm explaining this. So, and now Bhagavachanam. Ete Gardabhaha. And Gardabhaha is, you cannot put Asti, you cannot put Staha, you cannot put Bhavati or Bhavataha. Why? Because Gardabhaha Bhagavachanam. Ete Bhagavachanam. Therefore, the Kriyapadam must be Gardabha being third person, that is Pratama Purusha, it must also be in Bhagavachanam. And Bhagavachana form is Santi. So, Ete Gardabhaha Santi, you can say, or Ete Gardabhaha Bhavanti, you can say. Now you understand? Eshaha Gardabhaha Asti. Eto Gardabhau Staha. Ete Gardabhaha Santi. If you are referring to many things, then use Santi. If you are referring to two things, then use the Kriyapadam Staha. If you're referring to only one thing, then use Asti. Even if you don't use, it is understood. Either you can use Asti Staha Santi, or you can use Bhavati, Bhavataha Bhavanti. Both the meaning being the same, you can use any one. So, like the Shabda, what have you declined? Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha. Yeshaha, Etau, Ete. The same way, Kriyapadam also can be declined. It is Pratama Purusha will be Asti Staha Santi. Kriyapadam is Asti Ekavachanam Staha Dvivachanam Santi Bhagavachanam. So you have to supply accordingly. According to the Vachanam, you have to supply. Bhavati Bhavataha Bhavanti. Okay. We are going to see these forms in detail later. But now, you know this much. Understood? Yes? Or no?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Okay. This is not part of this lesson. But I just explained. Okay. This I will delete it. It will not be appear in the lesson. Okay. Now, moving on. the next sentence. Parvati ji, you can read.
Ete ajaha. Ete dakarantaha pullingaha eta shabdaha. Ajaha akarantaha pullingaha aja shabdaha. Eshaha ajaha. Eshaha ajaha. Etau ajau. Ete ajaha.
Can you supply the verb and say the same sentences?
Pardon me?
Can you supply the verb and form sentences in Ekavachanam, Dvivachanam and Bhagavachanam? We can use either Asti or Bhavati, anything.
Okay. Eshaha ajaha asti. Etau ajau santaha.
Santaha na. What is santaha? Staha. Yeah.
Staha. Ete ajaha santi.
Very good. Okay. Now the next line. Next, Sumati ji, you can read.
Ete simhaha. So the we can say ete, that is these are lions.
Yeah.
So that will be eshaha simha eshau edau simhau ete simhaha.
Eshaha simhaha. That visarga didn't say that.
Eshaha simhaha.
Asti.
Eshaha simhaha asti. Etau simhau staha. Ete simhaha santi.
Good. So you know what it means now.
Yeah.
Okay. You can mute now. So moving forward. So in the above sentences, balakaha, gritabaha, ajaha, simhaha, they're all masculine plural. Okay. Now, this Sumatiji, you can read this heading.
Chitrani Idishtha.
What is it?
I'm sorry, I'm not able to read that.
Okay. Can anyone read what is that?
Chitrani
Drishtva.
Drishtva. Drishtva. Dhru is written like that.
Okay. Chitrani Drishtva Eka Vachanani Dvi Vachanani Bahu Vachanani Cha Padani Likata.
What does it mean? You understand something?
Yeah, Chitrani, that is what we see to the picture. Eka Vach, that is whether it's a singular dual or plural. And plural, its cha is coming. Padhani, that is plural. Likata, that is you need to write it in that according to those forms.
Chitrani drishtva, seeing the pictures, write the singular, dual, and plural forms. Yata, as it is given. You can read this one. What you see now on the screen.
Eshaha, krishkaha.
What is it? Krishtaha.
Krishkaha.
It is, why Krishkaha? What is a center?
Sha. Isn't then, it Sha?
Yeah, it is Sha only.
Krishaka.
Again?
Krishkaha.
Why Krish? Why you are cutting the vowel? Is it not Hindi, right?
Okay, sorry. It is Krishakaha.
Then, say it together.
Eshaha Krishaka. Krishkaha.
See, you say kru sha
shakaha.
That when you say it together, you are making it krishkaha. How that shakara dropped its vowel.
Krishakaha.
It's not so difficult. Krishakaha, right?
Krishakaha.
It is krishakaha, simple. Krishakaha.
Krishakaha.
That Hindi will not apply here.
Okay. Okay, yeah.
You cannot sacrifice the vowel for the sake of, I mean, like Hindi. There is no sacrificial no vowels in Hindi. The vowel has to be pronounced as it is. In Hindi, always we cut the last vowel or any, even in between also. But in Sanskritam, nothing like that. As it is written, so it must be pronounced. Krishakaha, you said. Then say it together. Krishakaha.
Krishakaha. Sorry, Krishakaha. So, Eshaha Krishakaha. This is a farmer.
Okay.
Etau Krishakau.
Etau, that is tau.
Etau Krishakau. Ete Krishakaha.
So, this is a farmer. These two are farmers. These are farmers.
These are farmers.
You can supply the verb. Already you know. Astishaha Santiyaha. You can supply. This is an example given. So the exercise comes below.
Yeah.
This also, it's okay. You can also read this.
I am Rishabha. Imau Rishabau. Ime Rishabaha.
Okay, fine. And now, Krishnanji, now you know Chitrani Drishtva. Chitrani Drishtva, that Padani Likata. Whatever that padam is missing, that you have to write.
Eshaha Ballukaha, Etau Ballukau, Ete Ballukaha.
Ballukaha, okay, that O is long.
Ballukaha.
Ballukau, Ballukaha, right? So now you know what is Ballukaha. Chitrani Drishtva.
Beer. Eshaha Ballukaha. This is a beer. Etau Ballukau. These two are beers. Ete Ballukaha. These are beers.
So you are filling the blanks with the Dvivachanam form. Therefore, Etau, that is the exercise. Okay. Ballukaha is there. And it is the last one is plural. Ballukaha. Therefore, Ete Ballukaha. The next one also you can do.
Mandukaha. Okay. Eshaha Mandukaha. Etau Mandukau. Ete Mandukaha.
Mandu, here also it is long.
Mandukaha.
No translation is required because we understand from the picture what it is. Mandukau is there. Jivachara form is there. From that we have to understand the Pratipadika. Mandukau is there. Ramau is there. Pratipadikam is Rama. Mandukau is there. Therefore, Pratipadikam must be Manduka. Right? And when you decline Manduka, Mandukaha, Mandukau. The Mandukau is here. So now you know the Ekavachanam. Therefore, you can fill it in. Eshaha Mandukaha. And Eshaha is there. And Mandukau is Dvivachanam here. Therefore, Etau, Mandukau, and the next one, Ete Bhagavachanam is there. So you have to fill in with the Bhagavachana form of Manduka, which is Mandukaha. That is Manduka. You understood that. The next one also you can read.
Kapotaha. Eshaha Kapotaha. I am.
Okay, it's not Eshaha, it's good. Here, Imo is there, therefore, Eshaha cannot be used.
I am, I am Kapotaha. Imo, Kapotau. Ime, Kapotaha.
Very good. The next one, Arunaji, you can read.
Eshaha Paryankajaha, Eshaha Paryankaha. Etau Paryankau. Etaha Paryankaha.
Etaha? What's a new word?
Eshaha.
Yeshaha, that is also a new word. We never saw that such words now. I mean, as of now. Yeshaha, yet.
Sorry. Yeshaha, Paryankaha, Etau, Paryankau, Ete, Paryankaha.
Remember, it is Ete. Right?
Yeah.
Next one. You can continue.
Ayam, Kakaha, Imau, Kakau, Ime, Kakaha.
Good. You know, meanings are not required because you know from the picture. Then next one also you can read.
Eshaha, Sauchikaha, Etau, Sauchikau, Etaha, Sauchikaha.
Again, Etaha.
Oh, sorry. Ete, Sauchikaha.
It is meant it is not yet gone to your mind.
Eshaha, Sauchikaha, Etau, Sauchikau, Ete, Sauchikaha.
Okay, let me ask one thing. And do you all study Sanskritam in the other days? Because we have only one class a week. We meet every Friday. And after 7 days, 6 days, we are meeting again. What happened in the 6 days? Do you read Sanskritam? Do you practice?
Or yes, is...
Okay, I'm not asking. I'm not asking only Arunaji or Smatiji. Just asking in general, okay?
Yes, we do.
So it is important. It's not once a week. It must be daily 10, 15 minutes. And later when we study further, we keep adding a lot of things. So a lot of homework is required. Right? Okay. You have to spend some time. Daily 10, 15 minutes is important. The next one. Uttaraji, you can read.
Okay.
You see the picture, what it is, and here the word is given in Bhagavachanam.
Now Rishabha.
You have to identify the Pratipadikam and also here Etav is used. So what must be the Pratipadikam?
Okay.
And when you have to know the Prathama Bhakti Ekavachana form, Dvivachanam is given, Bhagavachanam. All these things you have to do mentally, quickly and do. So that is Abhyasa.
Okay. Yeshaha.
Rishabha, not okay, this short.
Yeshav, Rishabhav.
Yeshav is a new word.
Etau, Rishabhav. Ete, Rishabha.
There is no Yeshav. You can note down. There is no Yeshav for any Etau. Gender. Okay. Etau must come, not Yeshav. Okay, you can continue, Uttaraji.
Etau kau.
What is etau kau? Now you know the interrogative pronoun also we have seen.
Mm-hmm.
What is kau?
Kau is makarantaha pullingaha kim shabdaha.
It means? What does it
mean? What?
What? So etau kau, how do you translate?
Etau kau. What is this?
It is one. What is this means?
Two, yeah.
Then translate. Etau kau. How do you translate? Etau kau. What are these two? Simple, right? There's no complication in this. Etau kau. Etau kau, both are in Dvivachanam. So two things are there. And you want to know what are these two things. What are these two? Simple.
What are these?
If only one thing is there, Eshaha Kaha, what is this? Mm-hmm. Right?
Okay.
We have seen this. It's not new. We have seen in the previous class. We have used Kim Shabda.
Etau.
Kaha Kau Ke, we have used. Okay. Continue. What is
Etau?
Yeah. What is Etau? What is it given in the picture? What is given in the picture?
Dog.
What is the word for dog? There are so many words are there for dog. That also we have seen.
I couldn't recollect any name of dog
You should develop your vocabulary also. Daily, learn a few words. I have given a long list both in the level 1, that file, word file, I've given a long list of words, and also in the workbook also given a long list of words, and also
But I couldn't recollect right now what
Etau. I've given a long list of words. You have to go through the words. You will remember something. Okay. Mm-hmm. Dog means dog. Okay. The word for dog is kukkura.
Kukkura. Okay.
Kukkura or sarameya or shunaka.
Kukkura. Yeah, right. I know. Mm.
Kukkura.
Etau. Kukkurau.
Very good. Kukkurau.
They're all pulling sabda.
Exactly. Pulling up. Kukkura, sarameya, shunaka, all these are akaranta pulling.
Pulling.
Okay. Then next one also you can continue. Read.
Etau. Kau. What are these?
What are these? Many are one or only two?
Two.
You have to say two.
Okay.
What are these?
What are these two?
Yeah. Cow is specific. We are referring to two things.
What are these two? Imau bhali balivartau.
Balivartau, not balivartau.
Balivartau. Imau balivartau.
Practice that long and short. Many people I see, they were making a long, short, short, long. If it is long, it is long. Bali Vardau. Bali
Vardau. Bali Vardau.
Bali Vardau means what? Now we can understand.
Bull, no?
Yeah. So, Bali Vardau. How many bulls?
Two.
These are two bulls. How do you decline Bali Vardau is there? What is the Pratipadika?
Bali Vardau. Bali Vardau. Bali Vardaha. Bali Vartau, Bali Vartaha.
Good. Right? It's not difficult. Simple. Bali Vartau is the connect to Ramau. Ramaha Ramau, Ramaha.
Ramaha.
Bali Vartau, Bali Vartaha.
Bali Vartaha.
That should set in your mind. That's the Abhyasa. Right? Okay. The next one. Jayantiji, you can read. Patraji, you can mute your mic now. Jayantiji, are you there?
Yes, yes, Sharanji.
Shadri.
Siu, etau kaha.
Etau kaha? Only one bag is there. You are saying etau is dvivachanam and kaha is dvivachanam.
Okay. That's kim kaha.
Kim kaha. Okay.
Kim kaha.
What word will come in the blank? What is that is a question, right? So the question is dash kaha. The answer is given. And what is the answer?
Yeshaha syutaha.
What does it mean?
This is
a bag. Yeshaha syutaha. Then what will be the question now?
Yetad kaha.
Yetad kaha.
Yeshaha kaha.
That's it. Yeshaha kaha. Yeshaha syutaha, you are saying. Same yeshaha must come here, right?
Okay. Sorry. Yeah.
Understand, right? Or is it difficult?
No, it's not difficult. I got little confused with that. I have to do my homework.
Okay. The next one. Oh, here some mistake is there. Okay. You can, I will type now. You can read.
Yeshaha syutaha.
Okay, you can read the question first. You can supply the answer.
Yetau kau. Yetau syutau.
Right? Yetau, what does it mean?
What are these?
These two.
What are these? These two bags.
What are these two? Not these two bags. Yetau kau. What are these two? Then
what
you are answering, your answer is, these two are bags. Etau, syutau.
These two are bags. Okay.
Etau, kau. What are these two? Kau referring to two things. You are asking what. So, what two? What are these two? Etau, by supplying etau, by filling the blank with etau, you are asking, it means, what are these two? Etau, kau. Etau, syutau. These two are bags. The answer is syutau. For the cow, answer is Syutau, and referring to that which is very closer. Therefore, Etau.
Yeah.
Right?
Okay.
The next one you can.
Ete ke. What are these? Ete Syute.
Syute?
These.
That's a new word again. I never used
Syutaha. I'm sorry. Ete Syutaha.
You have to do a lot of homework.
Yes, sir.
You have to refer to the previous classes. Ete Syutaha.
Syutaha. Yeah. These are many. These are bags.
Bags. Okay. See, the problem is we are slowly learning, adding one by one to our knowledge. So the things will get add up slowly. So whatever we learn or we have learned, up to that we must be familiar, we must be thorough. That's right. We have not learned a lot in quantity wise. We have learned only few things. That too in the summary, when you see, always in summary, I give a summary. Summary is simple. That much only we learned. That we have to practice in a week time. This certain amount of time should be dedicated for learning this. Why? Because later when we move forward, then these things, when it is not understood or when it is not remembered, that those things what we are going to learn, you will find it difficult. And naturally what will happen? They will say, Sanskritam is not for us. So this is how many people, they turn away from Sanskritam. The language is not difficult. Any language for that matter, we have to put effort.
I will do my homework.
This is not only for you. I am just saying general. People, they blame the language for being difficult. It is, language is not difficult. But do we spend time in learning the language? That is a question. Any language, whether it is Sanskritam or French or Spanish, we need to give that much time. Our mind should become familiar with the language. For that, we need to spend a lot of time with the language. That's why I give a homework also. Anyway, so please spend some time in going back and listening to the classes which are there in the YouTube. You can listen to it again.
Okay.
Okay. And this batch, it has about more than 50 students in the group, but not all of them come. Hardly even 50% come. Either they don't do the homework or they drop out, or I hope they listen from the YouTube. Whatever may be, I don't know. But still, they don't give time for learning. That's why they say the language is difficult. It's a sad thing, really. Our language, since we don't give time, we are not in a position to learn and appreciate the language. This is the condition of many people. I know it. Being a teacher, I have seen many students just sharing what I know. Okay. I'm not referring to anyone. I'm just saying in general. So let us, whoever stays here now in the class, the balance left out. At least for them, I'm saying. So that you will also not, after some time, turn away from the language. Oh, it's difficult. That's a piece of, not advice. Something which I would like to tell. Okay, fine. So another exercise is there, which we have to do, but we don't have time. Only after we do that, I can give you the homework. Okay, I'll do one thing. I'll copy this, I'll send you. You can do this as your homework. I will read this. If you have any doubts, you tell me. So you have to fill in the blanks. So this one as well as another one also, I will send you as the homework. Okay, so Ruktasthana ani Purayata. You see there? Ruktasthana ani Purayata. Fill in the blanks. I have given four examples here. I am Kavihi. Kavi means, poet. I am Kavihi. इमौ कवि इमे कवयः अयम कविः दिस इज अ पोएट इमौ कवि दीस टू आर पोएट्स इमे कवयः दीस आर पोएट्स मेनी पोएट्स सिमिलरली अयम आकुः दिस इज अ रैट आकु मींस रैट आर माउस इमौ आकु उकारांत शब्द गुरुः गुरु दैटफॉर आकु इमे आकवः लाइक गुरवः दीस आर मेनी रैट्स अयम पिता The next one. This is a father. Imau pitarau. These two are fathers. Ime pitaraha. These are fathers. This is pita is rukaranta shabda. Rukaranta is there. Then the next one. Yeshaha harihi. This is hari. Hari is a person. Etau hari. These two are haris. Ete harayaha. These are many haris. Many people with the name Hari. In the same way, now you have to fill in the blanks. I am dash is there. I am dash. What is the proper noun? That is not given. That is given here. Ravi is there. Therefore,
I am Ravi.
I am
Ravi.
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 I am Ravi. And here, in this blank, Ravi is there. What will come?
Imau.
Imau, Ravi. These two are, what is Ravi? Son.
Son.
This is a son. These two are sons. S-U-N. Okay, not S-O-N. And Ime dash. What will come?
Ravayaha.
That is the lesson. Okay. So, you have to fill in the blanks. And in addition to that, I'll send you another homework also. You can go through that. If you have any doubts, you can ask me through WhatsApp. Right? So, we'll stop here. I've got another class now. So, we'll stop our class here. Any doubts? Any doubts you have? If you have any doubts,
Sharanji.
No, Thank you. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om Thank you.
Dhanyavada. 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 Dhanyavada.